Welcome. My name is Bruce Haber, and I'm with the HUD Office of Lead Hazard Control and Healthy Homes. Today we are in Baltimore, in front of this 1940s home, to produce two videos on lead-based paint inspection and a second video on a risk assessment. Combined, they are commonly referred to as a LIRA, or L-I-R-A, lead inspection risk assessment. We're going to produce this first video on how to conduct a lead-based paint inspection, and in order to do that, we want to go meet our inspectors. So here we are with our certified lead inspector risk assessor couple, a husband and wife team, of Terrell and Bill, who are here to tell us how to do a lead-based paint inspection. But before we do that, I want to know, why would we want to do a lead-based paint inspection?
Okay, there are a number of reasons why we might want to do a lead-based paint inspection. Sometimes a buyer is buying a home and the disclosure form, the seller said that he or she did not know whether lead-based paint was present. So the buyer wants the home tested to see if lead-based paint is present. In other instances, a homeowner wants to do renovation, so it's important to know whether lead-based paint is present prior to the renovation so that you can make sure you're taking the appropriate safety precautions. Landlords may want to prove that there is no lead-based paint present because they've completed a lot of renovations, and they just want to show the rental office that no lead-based paint is present so that they can legally rent their property.
All right. Thank you. And so what is the equipment that's used in order to do a lead-based paint inspection?
Okay, the equipment that we use to perform the inspection, we use an XRF device, X-ray fluorescence, because it's a non-destructive way to test paint. And with this particular device, we have any block that we use for quality control so that we can tell whether the machine is working properly or not. And the inspector wears a dosimetry device to make sure that the inspector is not being exposed to excessive levels of radiation. And prior to entering homes, we wear shoe covers so that we are not inadvertently contaminating the property with potential lead from another place. And I always bring a notepad or some sort of device to take notes, because at the end of all of this, we have to generate a report.
Ah, very good. So what's the first thing that we have to do in order to get the inspection going?
Okay, the first thing we have to do to get the inspection going is to calibrate the XRF instrument.
Okay. Well, while Bill does the calibration, how about Terrell, you and I, we go on inside and take a look at the house.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
Okay, to start any XRF job, we've first got to calibrate the machine. Calibration is done by testing a manufacturer's block that has known levels of lead on it. We do it at the beginning of the job, and if it's a long job, we do it every 4 hours, and we do it at the end of the job. In a multi-unit job, we do it in the beginning, between each unit, and at the end of the job. Reading was fine.
While Bill is out finishing up the calibration, I wanted to talk with Terrell a little bit about what we're testing in this room.
Okay, in this particular room, we're going to start by testing all four walls. Then we work our way up. We test the ceiling. This room has crown molding. We'll test the crown molding. There is a vent in the ceiling, so we'll also test the vent. We'll come down. We'll test the radiator. We will test the baseboard, and we will test the floor. Then we start testing window components. This room has a closet, so we will test the closet, and we will end by making sure we test the door components as well.
Do we test every room in the house, or just a couple of them here and there?
That's a great question. We test every single room or room equivalent. Some people don't consider a hallway or stairwell a room. We test those as well, and we do the exact same thing. We test every wall, we test the ceiling, we come down, we test baseboards, whatever components are in each room, we will test them all.
And for a multifamily property, is there any difference there either?
It's basically the same. The primary difference in a multifamily property outside of the individual rooms in the units are common areas, like hallways, stairwells, laundry rooms. So those would be tested as well. And one other difference in multifamily, unlike a house where we have to test every single room, in a multifamily, we do not necessarily have to test every single unit. HUD has a table, 7.3, that you go to. If there are more than 10 units, you want to go to that table so that you can see exactly how many units need to be tested.
I see. And it looks like Bill is ready to do the XRF testing, so I think it's time for us to get out of the way and you two can get back to work.
Wall B, windowsill, white wood. Wall B, window casing, white wood.
We're down here in the basement. We've completed the lead-based paint inspection testing of the first floor and the second floor. We've done bathrooms, we've done kitchens, living rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, and now we're down here in the basement. So, Terrell, what is different? Is there anything different about this large room here than there is the other rooms we've been in?
The primary difference in this room is the size, but the testing is the same. We look around for painted components. We want to make sure we test all the components. For instance, no other room had an I-beam. So we will be testing the I-beam here. We will be testing the support beam there. The windowsills here are definitely different. The ones upstairs were made of wood. And the staircase here, for instance, we have stringer, stair tread, stair risers, banister, post. And we would also have to test under the stairs as well, if anything is painted under the steps.
And you're right, there is paint underneath there.
Okay, so we would have to test that as well. And this basement, although it's large, it is subdivided into some additional rooms, so we would have to test those rooms, just like another room.
Okay, very good. With that in mind then, since we do have more than just one large room, a couple other small ones, let's get Bill back in here and finish up the XRF testing. Done. Okay, so the lead-based paint inspection is completed. What did we find out?
Well, we found that lead-based paint is present on the inside of the property. Lead-based paint is present also on the outside of the property. So with the notes I collected and the information from the machine, we're going to generate a report for the homeowner that will be used for the life of the property because the house isn't going to grow any new lead. While we were here, we also noticed some paint deterioration. So next, we're going to perform a risk assessment.
Well, thank you for joining us in this lead-based paint inspection video. Our next video will be the risk assessment process to identify any lead-based paint hazards that might be on this property.